Most of you don't know this, but there's somebody I've been gal fanning for such a long time. And I actually managed to get her. I actually managed to get her to come and do an interview with me for us for the International Decade of People of African Descent. Wait till you know who it is. Sarah, welcome to our small show. And I'm so happy to see you here, to have you here to talk to you. Sarah, please tell us a little bit about yourself.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm really honored that I can talk to you here a little bit. First of all, my name is Sarah Atinuke Akanji.
Oh wow, that's a mouthful. What does Atinuki mean?
Atinuke is my second name, and my dad gave it to me because it means that you're someone who is acting out of the heart, and I think that's a beautiful meaning.
Oh, that is so amazing. Atinuki. I think after this interview, I'll only call you Atinuki, if I may.
You may, absolutely. I think my dad will be very happy to hear
Oh,
so.
okay. That's amazing. Now, tell us a little bit more about your personal stuff, like what you like to do. In fact, I just want to know a little bit about you, and I want the rest to know a little bit about you. I need more about you than they do.
All right, sure. My dad is Nigerian and my mom is Swiss. I grew up here in Switzerland with two siblings, and all of us love to do sports, so we kind
Oh.
of connected while doing sports.
Okay.
And I was very young when I realized I had a different skin color and I didn't really feel like I belonged. But through sports, I kind of connected here in Switzerland. So I think that was really nice that we had that as a family.
Okay. What kind of sport do you mean? Do you like go to the gym? Do you jog every day?
Yeah, first it was hard because I kind of loved doing different sports. But then with time, I just found out that my passion belongs to soccer.
Oh, I was gonna say dancing.
Dancing? Yeah. That's what most of our people, white people, tell about me, that
Yes.
you have to dance.
Yeah, I know, I know. Okay. But soccer.
Yeah, exactly. I don't know. It's just the team sports
Oh,
and
wow.
everything you just have, you play with a team, and it's really important that you have technique and the tactic and everything. And I just kind of loved it to play soccer, be out there.
Wow.
Doesn't matter what weather it is, if it rains, if the sun shines, and I kind of loved it.
Okay. But do you play like in a team with guys or soccer? You know,
Yeah.
when I think of soccer, it's a male-dominated sport, so soccer.
It definitely is still a male-dominating sport, but it changed over time. So more and more girls start to play soccer. But when I was young, I played with boys because where I grew up, there were only boys who played at a club. But then over time, right now, I'm playing for FC Winterthur.
Yes.
That's where I live. And we're just girls and women playing together because right
Wow.
now there are enough women who do sports, who play soccer and who love it.
Okay.
And I just love to play with other women who just have this passion for the
Oh,
sports
cool.
we share.
That's really cool. If I'm not gonna do it. I'm too old. I'm just asking for you guys who are watching us. If I wanted to play soccer, and join a team, which would be a good way of getting quickly into soccer, what do I have to do? Do I have to like be extra strong, or do I have to write to the team? How the hell do I get there? Or do I look for you? How do I get there?
You actually don't have to kind of have a certain age or to, I don't know what you do, but you just have to be there and you just claim the place. You go there, I like playing soccer, can I play here? And I
Okay.
think it's really important that the clubs have this openness to tell you, yes, you can come here and play with us. Because I think it's really important if you love something and you like to do something, that you just do it and you go there and you tell them, I want to play soccer, it doesn't matter how good I am, but please give me the opportunity. And then I
Okay.
think you should just go there, get it, and claim it.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Speaking of claiming it, are there a lot of people of African descent in your team or in female soccer?
Actually, not with women. I haven't played against a lot of women who have African descent. I think there are very few,
Why?
sadly. I don't know. I think maybe it's kind of difficult to just go there and to connect and everything. And I think that's not just in soccer. It's like we live here in a world, or in Switzerland, we live here with a lot of white people. And it's just like you always have this feeling like you don't really belong that much. I think you know what I'm talking about, right?
Oh, yeah.
So it's really hard to overcome this and to just go there and say, hey, I want to be here. I want to belong. I want to do something.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Now that you claim we should try, we will try. And that's a very powerful message you just said right there about you should just try, you should go there. And show that you want to do something, show that you want to belong, that you do belong, because if we don't take up this space, who else will be able to know that we are here, recognize our presence, give us this opportunity? And I think Sarah is doing an amazing job with it. And Sarah, we have this International Decade for People of African Descent that was adopted in 2013, December 2013, actually 23rd December 2013, by the United Nations General Assembly. And it was, well, then in 2000, it was declared for 2015 and it will run until 2024. This decade is, well, something really important for us. That's why I'm trying to launch it with all those who want to help me do this on 21st of March in Landes Museum in Zurich from 4 p.m. And we will have a small cultural festival. So why are you going to come for this cultural festival? Because she is coming.
Yeah, I definitely will be there. And I think it's really important to go there to connect with people who are kind of have the same experience. We all have a different identity, but somehow we have something that connects us. The kind of the feeling that I said before, that we kind of always get the feeling you don't really, really belong here. Yeah. And I think we share the same experience. And I think it's beautiful to go to a place and meet people where you belong, you know, where you have the whole feeling that you belong. And I think there are beautiful cultures out there. And I love to meet new people, get to know their culture, because obviously Africa doesn't have one culture like a lot of people think here. And I think it's just awesome to connect, to network, to share experience, to be there. And also, I think it's important for the public to know, to show them we belong here. Migration happened. And even though we sometimes get the feeling that we don't belong, we just show them we do. We are here and we take our place. And we're going to stay here if you want it or not.
Yes, we're here to stay. Like Sarah said, we take our place. And I firmly believe we all have a shared experience. That's what it means this whole decade, because it's dedicated to people of African descent. African descent means somebody somewhere in your lineage, somebody suffered from transatlantic slavery. Everybody who actually had repercussions of this, had things going on, they suffer under all of this, are considered people of African descent. Now, this decade is really, really important for us, and I hope you all come to celebrate it. Sarah, why would it be important for you as a person?
I think for me, it's important to show the world that we are worthy. We are really worthy.
Yes, we are.
And I think it's also important to show we belong here, but still, there is a problem with racism in our society. And I think we just can take this place and we can show the public we all experience racism, if it's structural or offensive. We kind of know both of them. And I know a lot of people who come to me, and when I tell them about racism, they're like, ah, no, you're just seeing it that way. And it doesn't really happen. It's just your feeling. And I don't think it's just my feeling. I think it's a thing we experience here in society, and here publicly we can tell the people, no, we do have a problem as a society and a long way to go. And I think it's really important that we have this platform to show the world, no, we are here, we want to work with that problem and we want to overcome it, and we kind of aren't just our skin color.
Yes.
We are the it's really important to see the person behind it.
Yes.
that's kind of my main message I want to bring here and to show the public.
We're more than just our skin color. You heard it. Sarah said it. You heard it from my main fan. I've been fanning this girl for so long. Please tell us again your middle name so we can all practice at home and call her like that next time we meet her.
My name is Sarah Atinuke Akanji, and everyone who wants to can call me by that name because I actually love it, because I love my African heritage. So you can call me Sarah or Atinuke.
Oh, I'm gonna do Atinuke. I'm gonna do Atinuke. Now for you guys, I'm getting myself something. I couldn't get a football today and I'm really bummed about it. But I'm getting myself something you're all going to be jealous about. I've been holding this so I don't forget. And Sarah is just about to sign my arm. Watch this space. Could you please do this for us? Please. I'm not going to wash this. Yay, yay. That's it. Thank you. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you
did
too.
Me such a... Yes, I love this moment. Thank you.